the time that we all had together on that first movie, I mean, it's irreplaceable. And the time that we've had on all of them, you know, we'll never get it back. We really, we'll always be in each other's lives, you know, we will. I've made friends for life. But it's, there's something special about that time on set, you know, it's like you're never really spending 16 hours every day, and then you're going home to the same hotel with them as well. Like, it's literally a 24-hour constant thing, and we all just voluntarily did that. We all just genuinely loved one another so much and had so much fun hanging out that we just never left each other alone, I guess, which is really cool, you know, and was always a part of what made this so special. And I feel like you feel that on screen too, you know. We were all just so pumped to be with one another. We all had such tremendous respect for one another. I just feel like Wes understood the language. He created it, you know. He understood the world. No one works harder than him, you know, and he's truly special. Yeah, reuniting on each one every time it's hilarious. It's just really exciting. Like, I turn into like a little kid again in a way. You know, because we've all gone on to, in between these films, we've had years of, you know, growing up. You know, we're in our mid to late 20s now, most of us, all of us. And I find myself kind of becoming that little, you know, my little crazy, like, energetic self who sprinted up to Thomas the first day I saw him in the production office on the first one, you know, and just wanted to meet him so bad, you know. And just that excitement that we all kind of, and energy that we all created with each other, you know, in the first movie, that just kind of snaps right back in, I guess. I don't know. As soon as I see everyone again, I'm just like, I turn into a person I only am with them, in a way. It's really cool, and I'm going to miss that, you know. It makes you work harder, too. It makes you more passionate about what you're doing. You have such a confident and smart leader, you know, who is giving everything he has every day to this thing. When we first meet Thomas, you know, I mean, we're meeting a scared and fragile, vulnerable kid, in a way. This little scared animal in a cage. And it takes him a little bit too. In that first film, I've always thought it was such a cool coming of age arc of this kid discovering that he has this leadership in himself, you know, and that this drive that he can kind of put these kids on his back and get them out of there. And with that, though, comes a lot of responsibility and a lot of wear and tear. You know, he really takes every loss that they go through to an extremely personal level. And now the Thomas that we see in the third film, you're seeing a very weathered person, you know, who's been through a lot, has felt everything, you know, and still considers it his job to protect these people. It's a whirlwind of emotions, and I think that that's a nice way to end what's been a whirlwind of a trilogy, I guess.